Rocket League Season 15 is live. It's the 5th of June 2024 and it is official that Rocket League Free-to-Play has had more seasons now than the initial legacy of Rocket League. So from this front page we can already see that it is the Salty Fest vibes in the background, which we saw in the Rocket League news just a couple of days ago. So what we're going to be looking at today is all of the rewards, all of the different titles which I have earned. We'll then take a look at the Rocket Pass and the tournament rewards as well. Then we'll take a look at the map. We'll have a quick look at the limited time mode update as well that they've done. And then finally we'll hop on into a game and hopefully we'll hear some demos and see the chat in the corner with the times. So let's hop on into Rocket League and take a look at our new rewards. So we managed to get up to Grand Champ, but unfortunately didn't quite hit the SSL, and we'll start off with the Season 14 GC wheels, which look tasty. We've got the silver ones, which could work quite well with titanium white, the diamond ones and the platinum ones to go with your blue cars. Then you have the champion and the bronze as well, and the gold. Sorry, I forgot about that gold one too. So that's all of the Season 14 gold rewards which I did earn this season. And now we'll take a quick look at the titles which we have earned as well. So it looks like the Season 14 titles have not yet dropped, but the ones we did manage to get this season were the Season 14 Grand Champ, Dunk Master, RNG Champ and Floor Destroyer titles. So once they drop, we'll definitely get equipping those. But we'll make our way now into the Rocket Pass and we will definitely be buying premium straight off the bat to make sure that we can go and take a look at all of the different items which can be won. So we will start off with the Nissan Fairlady Z wheels with the Nissan Fairlady Z. So here it is, the new car, the Nissan Fairlady Z, which looks all right, to be honest. Doesn't really go with the decal and all of the things I've got equipped right now, but it looks okay. The wheels looked a lot better than the wheels that I've got on right now. And then we have the Dominus Salty Luxury decal there in tier 2. Looks okay with the Mosh Maniac title. In tier 3, we've got the Mosher Luxury Rocket Boost. Quite a cool little rocket boost, to be honest. It's sort of like an animated explosion, a little bit anime sort of. In tier 6, it looks like they are the hi-hat wheels, which are sort of speakers, and they look pretty cool. I do quite like the look of those wheels. In tier 7 is the Zipped Luxury Paint Finish. Interesting paint finish, not one that I'm going to be using. The Indie Artist Player Banner, quite a cool little player banner there, along with the Breakout Ghosted Luxury decal there at tier 8. In tier 9, you've got the Producer Luxury Animated Decal, which is a really funky one, and it was one of the ones which we did see on the most recent news update on Rocket League. Pretty cool, I have to say, and I do like the fact that it's animated as well. You don't have too many of those these days. In tier 11, you've got the cool Rock On Luxury Antenna. I'll definitely be equipping that when I get up to that level. In tier 12, we've got the Punked Wheels, which have the belts that are wrapped around. Pretty cool, but it's just the weird colours, isn't it? It's too multicoloured for most people's stock Tanes and stock Fenixes. The Beach Day Luxury Avatar Border you get there at tier 13, along with the Flip Flop Luxury Topper. That looks okay. In tier 14, you have the first of the upgrades from the Nissan Fairlady Z. It is the Starting Grid car. That is pretty cool, I have to say. I do like it. With that number 23 on the side, it gives it that race sort of look, and we'll have to give it a go, to be honest. It is a Dominus hitbox, so not a car that I'm going to be using all the time in ranked, but definitely in the sub games tomorrow, I'm definitely going to be giving that car a go. At tier 16, you have the SPF Player Antenna. Pretty ugly, not going to be wearing that. The Elder Emo at tier 17. Tier 18, you get the Neo Viral Luxury Player Banner. Quite a cool little player banner, that one, along with the Devil Smile Style Luxury Decal. Does anyone even use the X-Devil car? I don't know. Someone have to let me know in the comments if you do use it. You have the Ollie Luxury Wheels, again with the painted in blue. And then the Mosher Luxury Trail, which will come out soon. It seems to be lagging loads. I think it's probably because loads of people have literally just gone on right now. But that Mosher Luxury Trail looks like it links up with that Mosher Boost from the start. And it is a cool little animated, anime sort of looking trail. The Octane Check Wreck Luxury Decal, ugly, not going to be using that. The Summer Hat looks okay. He's a little bit similar actually to what I've got on at the moment with the Mariachi hat there. And then the Over Easy Luxury Player Banner. At tier 24, you've got the Dry Erase Luxury Paint Finish. Again, not nothing that I'm going to do with that. I don't know, does anyone actually change any of their paint finishes? When was the last time anyone changed their paint finish? Because I feel like I very rarely change mine at all. At tier 26, you then have the Savage Spray Luxury Wheels. Pretty cool wheels, to be honest. Although, again, with all the different colours and the animation, I don't think people are going to be using it that are going for their sort of stock Tanes and stock Fenixes. after. That is the Grow Player Anthem from Phil Butcher. Pretty cool one. Definitely much better than the ones that we got in the last season. The Gizmo Plummy. No one uses that gizmo. We'll move on to tier 28 now. So tier 28 is the Breakout Jam Sesh Luxury Decal. Again, a little bit too much going on that decal for my liking. The Shubi Player title, the Punk Boot Luxury Topper there at tier 30. You then have the 2.5D Luxury Rocket Boost. Again, a very animated sort of looking boost. It is quite a cool one though as well. But I don't know, I think I prefer the first boost over that one. At tier 32, you then have the Bent Antenna. Interesting looking one, don't think anyone will be using that. And the Sharp Tongue Luxury Antenna as well. So it doesn't look like it's animated, which we thought it might be, but it's a pretty cool one and it bounces around like any other antenna as well. At tier 34, you have the Skatefish Luxury Avatar Boarder, basically being eaten up by a fish right now by the looks of it. And then at tier 36, it's the Chill Egg in his boat by the looks of it going down the River Rapids. At tier 37, it's the Supporter Luxury Wheels. That's more like it. People are going to be using that one for their Stocktanes. And then the Octane Ragtag Luxury Animated Decal, which looks like someone's got really bad blurred eye vision. Looking at a blue car with clouds on it. Not a massive fan of that one at all. The Skullpunk Luxury Animated. The Skullpunk Luxury Antenna. Pretty cool one again there. And then at tier 40, you have the Nissan Fairlady Z RLE Luxury Body. So there it is, the upgrade of the Nissan Fairlady Z again with the spoiler there on the back. I do really like the look of this car and I definitely think they've done a good job this season with the car for sure. Then you have the luxury decal, which is very nice as well. It sort of gives it that vintage look, that decal with the red and the black, and especially with my wheels as well, it works quite well for this car. Just need to get rid of that antenna and then it would look sexy. And the Power Gourd Luxury Goal Explosion. Right, let's listen to that one again. Not a great goal explosion, to be honest. Don't think I'm going to be using that one. You've got the Fried Egg Luxury Topper right there, along with the Leopard Print Luxury Paint Finish. Again, another paint finish that's just going to be added to my garage, and that's all. Don't think you're hearing much of that skateboard engine. No one's going to be using that one, I don't think. The 2.5D Luxury Trail as well. So we had that luxury boost earlier. And again, it's the matching trail to go with it. Not the best of trails. The 11 Sens Luxury Wheels. They look okay. Again, though, it's the orange and the blue. Doesn't really work with one car. You either want it to be fully orange or fully blue, in my opinion. The High Tide Luxury Avatar Border there. Just like a wave going over the top of my head by the looks of it. The Candid Luxury Wheels, again, kind of might work with a Stocktane, but they're not the nicest of looking wheels. The Riveted Luxury Paint Finish there at tier 49. Again, nothing that I'm going to be using. And at tier 51, it's the Nissan Fairlady Z Luxury Player Banner. So that's a pretty cool player banner as well, but I definitely prefer the one which I've got equipped right now. The Grungy Luxury Wheels there, again, looks good. Bit more basic of the wheels, but maybe if you get those painted in titanium white or something, I'm not sure what will change, but if it's the whole of the middle bit that changes, that could look pretty cool. Then you've got the Band Battle Luxury Animated Decal. A little bit too much animation going on there, in my opinion. I don't think I'll be using that one. You've got the Merc Wingnut Luxury Decal. Not going to be using that. Who uses the Merc these days? The Flycon Luxury Wheels. I quite like those Flycon wheels, to be honest, and I hope maybe those might be painted. They're pretty cool. I do quite like those wheels, I have to say. Maybe once we get to tier 56, we're gonna have to be equipping those. At tier 57, you have the Quilted Luxury Paint Finish. Again, another paint finish which I probably will not be using, and the Light Rock Luxury Animated Decal. Man, that's quite a cool decal. I know people probably won't like this one, but I actually quite like that. It gives it that sort of space vibe, even though it's, I can see that it's sort of luxury rock where it's shining off the guitars and lightning bolts and things like that. But I do quite like that decal. Probably one of the better things in this update so far. At tier 60, you've got the Ollie Revolved Luxury Wheel. So I'm guessing that's going off of the skateboarding, the Ollie move. I'm not sure on these wheels. I have to say, I quite like them, but then at the same time, I'm not really sure what the white dots are doing going around it. Maybe it sort of goes quite well with the decal, to be honest, that I have got on right now. The Clash Flash Luxury Rocket Boost. Very, very coloured rocket boost, that one. But it looks okay. Probably won't use that one. I prefer the one again at the start. This is in tier two. The headliner player title. That's a pretty cool player title as well, along with the Nissan Fairlady Z, not stock. So this was quite a cool one as well. I quite like the vintage look of these Nissan Fairlady Zs. And again, it's probably a car that I'm going to have to try out once we get up to 63, but I will probably not be using it in ranks, unfortunately. The Savage Spray inverted luxury wheels. That's a lot better, to be honest, than the initial Savage Sprays. There is less colour on it, and it's pretty cool, the little see-through. It actually goes really well with the car, which I've got currently equipped, I have to say. And then at tier 67, it's the Clash Flash Luxury Trail to go along with that Clash Flash boost, which we saw just momentarily ago. The Demo Disc Luxury Animated Decal is on right now, and that is quite a cool one, to be honest. It's a shame that it's animated. I think that one would have looked really cool if that one wasn't animated, but you'll have to let me know in the comments what you think of that at tier 68. Tier 69, the Supporter Prismatic Luxury Wheels. Again, the multicoloured vibe. To me, this looks a little bit like you're playing that board game. Oh, what's it called? Trivial Pursuit, that's it, where you get all the different colours for the different questions and you've got to put it in the wheel. Let me know if you can see that as well or whether I'm talking absolute gibberish. And then finally, I like it. The Volume 11 Luxury Gold Explosion. It's not too loud. It's not too in your face. And I'll have to see when you get whether you get exploded backwards and stuff from this explosion or what happens. But a pretty cool one, I have to say. And that is all 70 tiers of the Rocket Pass. After that, you are going to be getting some painted stuff. That 2.5D Luxury Trail in titanium white looks pretty cool there. We'll have to have a look at the black Nissan Fairlady. Yeah, maybe that would work quite well as well. If there's any other painted stuff which we think looks pretty nice, the titanium white power cord. No, I just don't like it. It sounds like a Pokemon dying or something. Let me know what you think there in the comment section below. That was a really strange one. Do what a painted Volume 11 Gold Explosion. That's quite a cool one in yellow, just a bit golden. That definitely doesn't go well with the car that I've got on right now, but I can see that one working as well, the yellow there. The one of the titanium white, the Demo Disc Luxury Animated Decal again. I definitely don't think it should have been animated. If they hadn't animated that one, it would have been a lot better in my opinion. But that is going to be all of the Rocket Pass. And now we'll take a quick look at all of the different tournament rewards. So the Spellbound Goal Explosion is to begin with. Everything's really slow at the moment, obviously, because everyone has just got on the game. I like it. It's sort of giving the Harry Potter vibes slash, I forgot what the name of the guy is, Dr. Zed or something? The guy that does this with his hand in Avengers, and then not Avengers, in Marvel, and it produces these little portals for things to go through. I forgot what it's called. Is it Dr. Zed or Dr. Someone? Someone's going to have to correct me in the comment section below. Then you've got the Staggerfish style Radiant wheels. I have to say, these wheels are a lot cooler than most of the wheels in the other Rocket Pass. I do quite like these. They sort of go with the vibe of the wheels with the dots around the outside, the black wheels with the dots. But again, I don't think it's something that I'm going to be equipping this season. Then you've got the Polyhedral Boost. That's cool. I like that little polyhedral boost with the die coming out of the back. Yes, I like that. I like that one. Let me know what you think in the comments. And the 1D, 2D topper there, the deluxe topper. Very nice. Sits on the top. Got lots of numbers which you can roll. The polyhedral deluxe trail. So you can get the full set of the polyhedral there by the looks of it. But I do quite like it. I'm not a massive fan of the trail though. I don't like the dice being coming out of the side. I think it would have looked a lot better actually there without the dice. Then you've got the tip-off import wheels, which is like a basketball going up and down there in the centre. A little bit strange, doesn't really go with the theme in my opinion, but definitely won't be using those anyway. The stagger-style deluxe wheels there, they look okay as well. That's all right, Player Anthem, to be fair. I can get down with that Player Anthem. That one works, that one works. And then you have the Mallet Topper there. That's a pretty cool little topper to equip to your cars. The Fine Line Sport wheels, definitely the best of the wheels which we have seen so far. But again, I'm not a massive fan of the green. If that was blue, maybe if you've got that painted blue, that would look pretty cool. You've got the Torch Special Antenna. Again, a little strange one that goes on the top there, but it's quite basic and I do quite like it. So it kind of looks like a matchstick that's been set alight for a while there at the top. And then finally, the basketball hoop antenna as well, which is something that we won't be using. We need to start equipping this basketball stuff for when we play hoops. Maybe it gives you that extra bit of luck so we can get some wins and make our way towards GC. But now let's take a quick look at that new limited time mode update. So if I go into private match, create private match, in the game mode section now, you will see that we have lots of new modes, including beach ball, boomer ball, demolition, drop shot, rumble, extra special mode as well, which if you jump inside on that game mode, you're basically driving around hitting what looks like an Easter egg. So this is quite cool that they've included all these. G-Force Frenzy, Gridiron as well. So for all those NFL fans, if you want to play some Gridiron in your private matches, you can now do so. This is probably the one game mode which I hate the most. I just don't ever enjoy playing Gridiron, to be honest. You've got Moonball, Pinball, and Speed Demon, Spike Rush, Super Cube, and lots more. So there we go. That's all of those new limited time modes that have been added to the private match. And for all of you guys that join in with my sub games, we will be trying all of those out tomorrow. So make sure to join it. From 7 to 8:30 p.m. BST tomorrow, and I'll see you all there. And finally, before we hop on into a game to hear the new demo sound and the chat in the top corner, we're going to take a quick look now at the new map. So let's have a look. Salty Fest map. So as you can see here in the center is that new extra mode. This is the egg basically that comes with it, and you have basically the normal game mode, although it has got a little bit of a boomer mode side to it as well. But we'll start off on this side of the map, so you can see there that they have got this new Salty Fest festival going on there in the background, and you can see as well the crowd watching some eggs on guitar and drums just there. So pretty cool addition there with the new festival vibes. You've got all the stands with a skate park there in the background as well. You've got the roller coasters in the background there as well. Kind of looks a little bit like the GTA pier. I can't remember what the name of the pier is, but I quite like the look of that as well. Some quite high-rise stands as well over here. I've said as well about 15 times just then in a row. You then have, by the looks of it, the announcers, the commentators there with their Rocket League caps on. Just realised they're all 2D. I thought they were 3D by the looks of it from in front, but they are all 2D. Again, over here, it looks like it's a little bit downtown sort of GTA-style buildings. You've got, what's this over here? You've got the bullying beef bowl there. So there we go. You've got the cool little bit of graffiti there, the Octane Boom with the Dominus coming in with the swipe, and that is the Jest gift shop. And then around here you've got the Manning, another Manning, looks like apartment blocks or a hotel of some form. You've got the Salty Shores there, which looks pretty cool as well. All the high-rise buildings with the Psionics building there in that background too. I actually really like the look of this map, I have to say. And then you've got some Ferris wheel with all the different toppers. Look at that, that's pretty cool. So you've got the pigeon, you've got the police cat there. You've got lots of other hats as well. And then you've got the duck and the another hat there, the builder's cap. So quite a lot of cool little things going on in this new update. Let's have taken a quickly have a look at the parking through here. You see if we can drive down. No, unfortunately not. Nothing there going on in that parking, but it looks like it's got a diamond on the outside of it. So that's diamond parking. And then just another stand with a beach in the background. It's dusk like I was hoping as well. So nice little bit of dusk lighting. And there is the map. So little bits of sand, which you can notice at the goal mouth and the halfway line. But apart from that, I do really like the look of this map. And if I press play right now, you will see me score with the boomer on the egg. Let's watch that again. Smashed it into that top corner. You can see as well, when a goal goes on, the lights flash there in the background of the Salty Fest festival. But yeah, apart from that, that is all of the main updates with this map. But I think it's a pretty cool one. You'll have to let me know down in the comment section below what you think. But compared to a lot of the most recent updates of the maps, I have to say I think this one is definitely one of the coolest. And finally, we're about to hop into a game to see whether we can hear any difference in the explosions, the goal explosions, and the chat in that top left hand corner as well. So we'll see. We've gone into a quick casual 2v2 match, and we'll get a quick demo off the bat and see what happens. And there we go. So that is the sound of if one of me or my teammate gets demoed by the looks of it. And our teammate has just scored. And there you go. You can see as I put nice one in that top left hand corner, it now has the time. So it says 3:36, which is the time in the game, so that you don't get confused now when people are putting stuff in chat. And then this is the sound of a demo on one of their teammates, is it? I swear that both demos there sounded exactly the same. I might be incorrect. Does it depend on if your teammate demos them or if you demo them? I'm not too sure, to be honest. So I've asked our teammate to demo someone, so hopefully he will demo someone in just a second so we can hear what it sounds like when our teammate demos the opponent. And so that is the sound of a demo there from our teammate on one of them. That sounded pretty normal, to be honest, so we'll have to see what it sounds like when they demo one of our teammates. And that is it. So I played 5 games, and not in one of those games did the opposition demo one of my teammates. So I am not waiting any longer. We'll have to see in the videos whether the sound of the demos has changed between the different teams. But you have to let me know what you think of this new update down in that comment section below. And also, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you want to see some more Rocket League content. We've got lots of Season 15 ranked coming out shortly, mainly the fun modes, but we're going to try and incorporate a couple of normal modes in too. So I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next one.